Hey guys, actually I've run into some issues lately. The thing is, my Android phone, it sucks big time. Whenever I set an alarm and the battery drops below 30%, the alarm doesn't go on. So it really disturbs my daily routine, and so I need to get into work. I have an old atmega8 board that I'm not using it anymore, and I have an old RTC. So I'll be interfacing them to form a small simple alarm clock that really works. I'll just show you the atmega8 board that I'm using. It's a very old board that I got with the robotic kit, but I'm not using it anymore. So I'll be using the board along with an I2C controlled RTC module. It uses a DS3231 RTC IC. It also has an EEPROM, which I don't think I'll be using it. And for display purpose, I'll be using this 4-bit LCD segment. I assembled it on my own like 2 years back, just because I didn't have anything else to do. I think I'll put it to good use this time. So, get into work. Alright guys, so now we'll be looking into the software part, and for writing the code I'm using AVS Studio 4, which I'll be running on Windows XP from my virtual machine, because Windows XP is very low on resources, so it's very easy for me to run it on an Intel Atom processor. So this will be the code that I'll be using. I have already written the code and I just need to compile it. And so I have two separate files. One will be this RTC underscore func.c, which will be having all the functions pertaining to the I2C, which will take care of writing the time and reading the time, and also converting the BCD into decimal data. And this is the main code, and there I'll be having a main block and while loop under which the data will be continuously displayed, while the time will also be updated momentarily. So let's just go ahead and compile it and disable all, and that's it. So anyway, I have included all the files in the link which is given in the description below, so feel free to download. And please comment if you have any enhancements that can be done to the code, which I'll be very happy to acknowledge. So that's it. So we'll just move the code into the controller and see if it works. So hey guys, and so finally I've been able to put together a crude looking alarm clock, which I'm sure will work. And this is the RTC here, I have tugged it, and these are the wires coming out from the processor, I mean the controller. And that's it, it's a very simple arrangement. And just close it. I just need to find a way to tuck in all these wires inside to make it look tidy. So this is the buzzer, and this will be the display where the time is shown, and these will be the controls to set the time and the alarm. And so let's just switch it on and see if it works. Hopefully it should. So now the time is 10:10. So I'm just trying to set the alarm now. So let's make it 10:11. When the time is right,